and getting ready to go to work.
All right, guys, you may notice I'm wearing a white coat, and that is because I am working in endoscopy today. So typically anesthesiologists don't wear white coats, and the reason for that is white coats are not allowed in operating rooms. However, they are okay in the endoscopy suites because it's not really a sterile procedure. And what I am basically doing is supervising CRNAs today, and they're fantastic. The CRNAs I work with are very, very skilled. They're so talented. They could take care of me and my family any day. So it makes my job super easy. What I do is I meet the patients, I pre-op them, I evaluate them for anesthesia and make any changes as necessary, create a preoperative plan that I discuss with the CRNA, and then help them get the case started if they need to. I basically have to be around. When I supervise 3 to 4 CRNAs in the endoscopy suites, I have to be kind of available in case of an emergency. Emergencies do happen, and they have to happen a lot in endoscopy. So that is what I'm doing today, and it's so fun. I love talking to the patients, and I try to joke around a little bit, make them feel a little bit more at ease. So right now what I'm doing is I'm in a little dictation room, and I am immediately available. You can probably hear noises, and that's the sound of the doors being open and shut from all the endoscopy cases. So because of the nature of my job, I don't film, obviously, patients and patient care areas because, you know, it's a privacy issue, and that's more important to me than making a video. But I do hope that it kind of gives you an idea as I take you through my day, what I'm doing and how I'm doing it and what that entails, because some days I'm in the operating room taking care of my own patients and I love those days, but sometimes I'm supervising, sometimes I'm doing endoscopy, sometimes I'm doing cath labs, sometimes I'm doing obstetrics, sometimes I'm doing vascular or neuro cases. So I can pretty much do anything. Some people kind of like hyper specialize and really just don't feel comfortable doing things they haven't done in a long time. So I try to avoid that and keep all of my skills up by doing a little bit of everything all the time. So yeah, that's that. And I will check in with you guys a little bit later. Currently, if I didn't mention it, it's 10:22. So we've been going here for a couple of hours. I typically get to the hospital around 6:45. And then we start the day around 7 o'clock. So it's 10:22, and things are going great so far. So I'll check in with you guys a little bit later. All right, guys, so it is now 3:50, and I have taken over. A lot of our CRNAs actually leave at 3. So typically, since I work till 5, Monday through Thursday, I will relieve CRNAs or take over in some sort of capacity at 3 o'clock. So that's what I've done. I relieved a CRNA, and now I'm gonna do an EGD and stenting, and then get another patient ready at 5 o'clock. But since my shift ends at 5, one of my colleagues who works later than me will take over that responsibility, and then I'm relieved to go home, and you know, I get to kiss my baby. So so far we've done probably about 30 cases or so today, which is a pretty good number. It's fun to meet and chat with all these patients preoperatively and kind of joke around with them, and then I get to see them afterwards and check in on them when they're asleep. Of course, they're always like, I didn't see you in there, doc. I'm like, you were asleep. How would you know? So far, that is what's going on. And then I gotta finish. I think I have a few minutes of downtime for it to start this EGD stent. So I'm gonna work on some paperwork, the billing, submitting all the stuff electronically for billing. That's a huge part of an anesthesiologist's job, unfortunately. And then before I leave, I'm gonna go check the schedule for tomorrow to see kind of like where tentatively I'm gonna be assigned tomorrow. What is my hair doing right now? Most of the time I work in one hospital. It's my preference to just be in one hospital, and it's my preference to work all over the hospital. But sometimes I go work at a surgery center and stuff like that. So I like to kind of know where I'm going. So I know, like, do I need to wake up extra early? What time are my start times? Usually it's 7:30, but sometimes they're a little bit earlier, like 7 o'clock. So I'm gonna do these cases and I'll check in with you once I'm leaving work. All right, as promised, it is the end of the day. I stayed a little bit later, about 5:20. Really not that big of a deal. Just so I could finish taking care of a patient. So I am leaving the parking garage and I'm gonna head home and quickly relieve the nanny, kiss my baby, and I'm probably gonna try and do a little bit of that electronic paperwork. I never got a chance to submit the rest of my billing for the past 2 days, so I really, really need to do that. So I'm gonna I can do that on my phone, which is great. So it's like through a special compliant app that I can submit billing through, and it's like protected. So all in all, a really nice day, a really pleasant day. It really helps when you work somewhere that you get just really gel with all the staff. I feel like that's so crucial in anesthesiology. It is not a solo job. You work hand in hand with surgeons, gastroenterologists, cardiologists to help them do their procedures, and then you work with techs and CRNAs and AAs. I mean, there's just so many people. You have to really like the people you work with in this job. And fortunately, this job that I've been working at for almost the past year is like my forever job. I love it. I love the place. I love the hospital. I love the people. It's very fulfilling, and I'm very I feel very blessed to be where I am today. So I know that it's not the most helpful thing that I can't show you me actively doing my job, but it is a privacy issue for patients. Okay, everybody, it's the next day, and I'm sorry I didn't vlog at the end of the day yesterday, but I just got carried away. I hung out with my daughter, and then I actually made it an early night because I was kind of tired for some reason. Went to bed at like 8:49, I think 8:50. So today I'm in cath lab, one of my favorite places to be. So I will continue for, you know, a couple more minutes of footage here, and then that'll be it. So I am here in cath lab waiting on a physician, a cardiologist, to get here so that we can do a transesophageal echo under anesthesia. Usually those require anesthesia because it's basically uncomfortable. So I'm just waiting on that. I've spoken to the patient and everything, and it's really interesting because the patient is not the most straightforward case. So I've got everything ready, and I've got all the appropriate medications, and I've got emergency stuff ready, and I'm excited because I get to try a different type of oxygen mask that has a little cutout hole for the echo probe that goes in the patient's esophagus. So I'm excited. I'm like nerding out right now, but I'm excited to try this kind of new, normally we just use like a nasal cannula, so it's kind of cool. So I have done two TEEs. I'm getting ready. A TEE is a transesophageal echo where they put that probe. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier. I'm about to do a cardioversion, which converts someone from an abnormal rhythm to a normal rhythm of their heart. And after that, they've added on another transesophageal echo for a patient with possibly bacterial endocarditis, which is a vegetation or infection around one of the valves of the heart. So I went and saw that patient because they wanted to make sure that it was okay by me first and the patient would be safe under anesthesia, and I evaluated him and talked to him, and he looks great. So we're going to add that on, and then it'll be 3 o'clock. And as you know, as I mentioned from yesterday, at 3 o'clock I go usually relieve my colleagues or my CRNAs who only work until 3. Sometimes I'll just go from one complete spectrum to another. Like I will be doing pediatrics, and then I'll go to adult, or I'll be doing cath lab and I'll go to general or main OR. So it's all very in flux. In this job, you really have to be able to be adaptable, to go with the flow, to be easygoing. Like I said, I'm not the most easygoing person, but this job has trained me to be that, because you just have to be adaptable, flexible when you're in the field of anesthesia. And I've known people who are not adaptable and not flexible in this career, and it's to their detriment. So anyway, it's something interesting if you're considering the field of anesthesiology. So I will check in with you guys in a little bit. So I just finished my last case in cath lab. It's about 2 o'clock. I'm waiting for my 3 o'clock assignment, and somebody who just came from a procedure in the cath lab in the door next to me while I was doing a procedure, went into VFib arrest, which is ventricular fibrillation. I was able to pop my head out and see if they needed my help, but fortunately, after one shock, he was brought back to life and awake and breathing and all that. So my services were not needed, but I was there. Fortunately, I was very close by in case they needed me to put in an airway or something, but that's crazy. Literally stuff like this happens all day, every day. And that's part of why I love my job. I just love being needed every once in a while. Now, if it was constant, it would really wear me down, but it's just nice to be available and needed whenever bad things happen. So I'm gonna go get some lunch because it's 2 p.m. to eat, and then I'm gonna go take over a room probably at 3 o'clock, and we'll go from there, and I'll check in with you at the end of the day. Bye. Okay guys, as you can see, I am back home, and I want to end it here. I hope that you found it helpful. I ended up taking over a room at 3 o'clock, finishing that case, and then being the board runner, which means that you kind of coordinate all the rest of the surgeries and stuff, and basically holding the phone, which is like kind of the main anesthesia phone, for a couple of hours until 5 o'clock hit, and then one of my partners took over. So anyway, that'll wrap it up. It actually ends up being 2 days in the life of an anesthesiologist. Again, you can see they're both very different, but still equally fun, and tomorrow's a brand new day. Like this video. If you want to see more videos like this, like this video. Leave a comment saying that you want to see more videos like this, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Open eye, feel the waves cut through me, hypnotized by the sounds I'm breathing.